Hi students, welcome to Sri Chaitanya online classes. Welcome to our physics. The previous session we discussed progressive wave, reflected wave and its mathematical part, and also we discussed parameters of a progressive wave. Okay, now this session we are going to discuss equation for a the speed of a traveling wave. Okay, now look at the board. Equation for speed of a traveling wave. So now see, the speed of a traveling wave is nothing but wave speed. From the definition of wave speed, we discussed in the previous class what the v equal to omega by k. Yes or no? So v equal to omega by k, v equal to lambda by t also. Now see, here omega means what, angular frequency, that is equal by 2 pi by t. Next, k means angular wave number, nothing but propagation constant. What is the formula of propagation constant? K equal to 2 pi by lambda. Any doubt? No doubt. Now see, substitute this omega value and k value in the equation 1, that v equal to omega means 2 pi by t, by k means 2 pi by lambda. Up to here, any doubt? Now see, this look like a by b, c by d formula. So it can be written as a by b into d by c. Okay, the 2 pi get cancelled. So finally, what? That v equal to lambda by t. So again, wave speed definition, from the definition of wave speed is came. What are So the distance traveled by a wave per unit time is called wave speed. V equal lambda by t came. Yes or no? Yes. So this equation, it can be written as the v equal to lambda into 1 by t. Okay, the lambda by t can be written as lambda into 1 by t. But we know the 1 by t equal to what? The reciprocal of time period is called frequency n. Now substitute here, the v equal to lambda into n. It is also written as v equal to n lambda. This is the equation of a wave speed. V equal to and lambda. Okay, up here and out. Now write down this one. Next, then look at the board. The next one is the next relation. The relation between wave speed, frequency, and wave number. So, relation between v omega k. Now, you know, from the definition of wave speed, v equal to what? M lambda. Okay, it means frequency, lambda means wavelength. This frequency equal to 1 by t. Nothing but the reciprocal of time period is called frequency. Now substitute here, instead of n equal to 1 by t. So v equal lambda by t. Up to here, any doubt? Next one. Here, dividing and multiplying with the 2 pi on both sides. Okay, so the equation becomes v equal to 2 pi lambda by 2 pi t. Up to here, did you go? Okay, this equation, it can be written as now v equal to 2 pi by t and 2 pi by lambda. Okay, so now see the 2 pi by t equal to what amount? We know that omega equal to 2 pi by t. You know that k equal to 2 pi by lambda. Now substitute instead of 2 pi by t here omega. So v equal to omega instead of 2 pi by lambda equal to what? K. K. So v equal to omega by, this is the relation between wave speed and a wave frequency and a wave number, that is v equal to omega by k. Okay. Now note this one. The next derivation is equation for speed of a transverse wave. Along statistic. Along a stretched string is dependent on tensional force and a linear density. Now right here, the speed of a TW means transverse wave depends on tension force and the linear density. Okay. Now here, by using dimensional formula method, we can derive the speed of a transfer wave. So by using dimensional formula method. We discussed it in intermediate first year in the second chapter. Now write the dimensional formula of speed. The dimensional formula of wave speed. What am I? The wave speed equal nothing but distance by time. So distance by time is nothing but L by T. So it can be written as L for 1, T for minus 1. The equation 1. Read out. Next, the dimensional formula of tension force. Tension force. Nothing but F. F equal mg. So, this is what T equal to mg. Now, see, the dimensional formula of mass m to the power of 1. The dimensional formula of acceleration due to gravity is nothing but acceleration. Its dimensional formula is m to the power of 1, t to the power of minus 2. This is the equation. Any doubt? Next one, the dimensional formula of linear density. So, indicated by mu equal to what? Mass per unit length is called linear density. Now, right, the dimensional formula of mass is m to the power of 1. So, length means l to the power of minus 1. The length becomes upwards. The dimensional formula is minus 1. The time is, there is no need. So because the time is not there, yeah. So equation 3. Okay? Up to here, you know? Okay. Now see, the tensional force per unit length, the tensional force per linear density gives the wave speed of a transverse wave. Now do here, the tensional force by linear density, the T by mu Now write the dimensional formula of tension. What is the tension here? M to power of 1, L to power of 1, T to power of minus 2 by what is the dimensional formula of linear density? M to power of 1 and L to power of minus 1. Up here, read it out. Now see, this M to power of 1, M to power of 1 get cancelled. So the T by mu equal to L to power of 1, this L to power of minus 1 becomes here positive. So nothing but L to power of 1 into L to power of 1. So it is written as L square. So write up L square. The remaining is T to power of minus 2. Okay. Now the T by mu as it is, that L square T to power of minus 2, it can be written as L T to power of minus 1 whole square. Okay. Now see, from equation 1, L to power of 1 T to power of minus 1 equal to what? Wave speed. Wave speed means what? V. Okay. Now write here. From equation 1, the T by mu equal to V square. Okay. Now square root on the both side. Square root on the both side. So the V equal to square root of T by mu. This is the equation for speed of a transverse wave. Okay. Now this equation of a, again extra. So the equation for speed of a transverse wave. In solid body is V equal to square root of eta by rho. Okay, that eta means what? Rigidity modulus. Rho means what? Density. Rho means density of a ball. Okay. This is our equation for speed of a transverse wave along stretched string. Okay. Now I am repeating the class. Now see, the speed of a transverse wave along a stretched string is dependent on tensional force and linear density. But by using the dimensional formula method, we can derive this equation. Now write the dimensional formula of wave speed, that is V equal to L to power 1, T to power of minus 1. There is no mass, so there is no need. So next, the tensional force dimensional formula, M to power 1, L to power 1, T to power of minus 2. Next, the dimensional form of linear density is m to power 1, n to power minus 1, t to power 0. T to power 0 is no need. So that's why reason I not told here. So m to power 1, n to power minus 1 only. But the tensional force per linear density gives wave speed. So write the dimensional form of tension and linear density, m to power 1, n to power 1, t to power minus 2 by m to power 1, n to power minus 1. Now see, m to power 1, n to power 1 get cancelled. Okay, yes or no? So now the remaining, the L to power of minus 1 becomes L to power of plus 1. So L to power of plus 1 plus plus 1. What? L square T to power of minus 2. So L square T to power of minus 2, it can be written as L to power of 1 T to power of minus 1 whole square. Yes or no? This equation represents what? Equation 1, that wave speed. So instead of L to power of 1 T to power of minus 1 equal to V. So T by nu equal V whole square. Now square root of the both side here, what happens here? So V equals square root of T by nu. This is the equation of a transverse wave speed. Okay. If you take the equation of speed of a transverse wave along a solid body is V equals square root of eta by rho. So here eta is the what? Digitally modulus. Rho is the density of bar. This one is our derivation. Okay. The next derivation is equation for speed of a longitudinal wave. Nothing but speed of sound. Now see, we know the sound waves propagating through metal rods or organ pipes. Yes or no? This contains bulk modulus. That's why the speed of longitudinal wave depends on bulk modulus and density also. Okay, now write here the speed of a longitudinal wave depends bulk modulus. In some books the persons took a velocity only, but we are taking a bulk modulus and density. Okay, now see here, by using dimension formula method only, we can also derive the speed of a longitudinal wave. By using dimensional formula method. Okay. Now write the dimensional formula of bulk modulus. Dimensional formula of a bulk modulus, so indicated by T. So can you say one, what is the dimensional formula of bulk modulus? We discussed it in the intermediate first year, that is 11th chapter, mechanical properties of solids. Yes or no? So can you say one? So the bulk modulus B equal to bulk stress by bulk strain. Okay, the stress is nothing but, you know, the force acting work unit area. So also the pressure also same. The stress and the pressures dimensional formula both are same. So that's why this is here, right, the delta P. The bulk strain is nothing but here barometric strain, that is minus delta V by V. Here the pressure is increases means the volume is decreases. Okay. Now write the dimensional formula of pressure and this barometric strain. It is also dimensional formula of bulk modulus. But we know the barometric strain has no dimensional formula. Yes or no? Is now write here the dimensional formula of V equal to. So what is the dimensional formula of pressure? Pressure equal to what amount of force by area. So there is no dimensional formula. No dimensional formula of strain. Okay. Now right here. So force bar area is called pressure. Now force means what is the dimensional formula of force? F is called ma. M means m. A means l. T to the power of minus 2. Okay. Any doubt? No doubt. So what is the dimensional formula of area? Area means what? L square. Okay. Now see, the square and the L get cancelled. So M to power of 1 by L, nothing but M to power of minus 1, T to power of minus 2. This is the dimensional formula of bulk modulus. Because of the dimensional formula of bulk modulus is nothing but the dimensional formula of pressure or stress. Because of this, no? This barometric strain dimensional formula. We need out here. Now keep this equation 1. Next, write the dimensional formula of density. So, the dimensional formula of density. Okay, indicated by rho. So, now saying what is the formula of density? Mass by volume. Yes or no? So, what is the dimensional formula of mass? 10 to power of 1, 10 to power of 0, 3 to power of 0. So no need to write the writer in to power of 1. So what is the dimension formula of volume? L cube only. Okay. So what this becomes? N to power of 1, n to power of minus q. The 3 to power of 0, there is no need. So this one is the equation 2. Up to here, any doubt now? Okay. Now look at the book. So now see, the bulk modulus per density gives what a speed of a lateral wave. Now right here. The bulk modulus per density. Now write what is the dimension formula of bulk modulus? This one. What is the term? N to power of 1, L to power of minus 1, T to power of minus 2. Okay. Now what is the dimension formula of density? M to power of 1, L to power of minus 3. Write up. M to power of 1, L to power of minus 3. Okay. Then you note here. Now see here. So m to power of 1, m to power of 1 get cancelled. So the remaining b by rho equal to what l to power of minus 1 by l to power of minus 3. So this l to power of minus 3 becomes l to power of plus 3 minus this one what 1. So l to power of 2. Yes or no? Okay. Now write down. This one what? L square. So the remaining what t to power of minus 2. Okay. Now see, this b by rho as it is, this L square t to power minus 2 will be written as L to power 1, t to power minus 1 whole square. Now see, what is this dimension formula, length per time, nothing but what am I, velocity, yes or no? The b equal to L to power 1, t to power minus 1. Now write up, instead of L to power 1, t to power minus 1 equal to this v. That b by rho equal to v whole square. Okay. Now see, square root on the both side. Square root on the both side. What happens? That v equal to square root of v by rho. This is the speed of a longitudinal wave or speed of sound. That v equal to square root of v by rho. In some textbook, it have instead of bulk modulus elasticity, so v equal square root of e by rho also. Okay, so now see the speed of longitudinal waves in solids. Speed of longitudinal wave in solid body. That v equal to the square root of y by rho. Okay, y means Young modulus. Rho means density of a solid body. Okay, so in case of speed of longitudinal wave in air, that equal to square root of p by rho from Newton's formula. Okay, this one is our topic. I am repeating the once again, just listen here carefully. So our question is speed of a longitudinal wave or speed of sound. Now see, the speed of longitudinal wave depends on bulk modulus and density, but by using dimensional formula method only we can derive this equation. So now write the dimensional formula of bulk modulus. That is b equal to what m to power 1, l to power minus 1, t to power minus 2. So nothing but what? The bulk modulus equal to stress by strain. There is no dimensional formula of strain. Okay, but I got about the dimensional formula of bulk modulus equal to the dimensional formula of stress, that is pressure. Okay, that is what m to power 1, l to power minus 1, t to power minus 2. The equation one. The next one, the dimensional formula of density indicated by rho equal mass by volume. So the dimensional formula is what? M to power 1, L to power of minus cube. That's the equation 2. Now the bulk modulus per density is gives wave speed. That's why reason I wrote here the dimensional formula of bulk modulus and density. Okay, that is m2 to power 1, n2 to power minus 1, t2 to power minus 2 by m2 to power 1, n2 to power minus 3. Appear in doubt. Now see, this m2 to power 1, n2 to power 1 get cancelled. This n2 to power minus 3 becomes here plus n2 to power plus 3 minus 1. That is what? L square. Now I wrote here L square. The remaining word amount t2 to power minus 2. Now see equation L square t2 to power minus 2. It can be written as L to power 1 into t to power minus 1 whole square. Yes or no? So this L to power 1, t to power minus 1, which represents what? Velocity. So instead of this, write the velocity. V by rho equal V square. Now square root on the both side, that V equal to square root of V by rho. This is the speed of sound or speed of a longitudinal wave. In case the speed of longitudinal wave inside wall, V equal to square root of Y by rho. Y equal Young modulus, rho is density of solid wall. Okay, then in case of the speed of longitudinal wave in air, that is square root of A by rho according to Newton's formula. Okay, this is the derivation. We know the speed of sound in air. The speed of sound in air, how much? That is 331 meter per second. Where? At a 0 degrees centigrade. When at 20 degrees centigrade, the speed of sound is 343 meter per second. Okay? Then the speed of sound in air for mathematical calculation purpose, we can use this formula. I mean this value. Okay? So up to this session, we are discussed what among equation of a traveling wave, okay, and relation between V and omega and K. The next one, the speed of a transverse wave along its stationary strain. The last and final, the speed of a longitudinal wave or speed of sound. We discuss it now, okay. So, this entirely do practice in your home, nothing but you are practicing your home also. But open your study material, your textbook, practice now, and up to over the class.